Net presentation. I'm Breaky CPK of Honcast.com. Thanks for tuning in. I'm joined by the headhunter of GoSuGamers.net. And this is the GoSu Gamers World Cup Grand Finale, SK Gaming versus Fnatic MSI. Game one to get things kicked off here. It is a best out of five series. However, MSI is up 1-0 as a result of coming from the winner's bracket and it being a double elimination tournament. So just keep that in mind. It's technically game one, but MSI is up 1-0 in a best out of five series. It is epic. We're finally here, ready to get this kicked off. It is going to be amazing. I am feeling it in my bones, shaking all over the place. I'm so excited this is finally here. Like I said, though, I'm joined by the one, the only, the headhunter from GoSuGamers.net. He's going to be my co-caster. How you doing, man?
Doing great. Really excited. Band's getting thrown out already, and I just want this match to get started. This is just going to be an amazing series, and it's finally here is all I have to say.
Yeah, and they're really, we've been saying so much throughout the past couple of months even about finally getting to this point. So for it to finally be here, we've already said, you know, what needs to be said. It's just awesome to finally be here, and let's just talk about the teams individually. Of course, the banning phase is still going on here. It's, as you would expect, a lot of time is being spent on these bans. You know, there's just so much money on the line. Again, to reiterate that, $10,000 on the line for first place. The second place, I don't want to call them the losers by any means, because it's definitely not a loser for getting to this point with such a big tournament. The second place finisher will be receiving $5,000 in a prize, so that's obviously you're doubling it for winning this. Obviously, so much on the line, as well as a pride factor. You always know that is a factor in such a game like this. This is U.S. versus European. That's just another thing that you could even call this. There's just so many different things that are going on here. But the banning phase has finished, so let's go ahead and actually jump right into that. As far as the bans are concerned, we got Swiftblade, Dampier, Slither, Soulstealer, Bombardier, Thunderbringer, Gladiator, and Pharaoh. So we were talking about this in the pregame, whether or not we were going to see Gladiator banned with, it looks like, where was it banned? It's been with a third ban by SK Gaming. They did indeed ban Gladiator. So your thoughts on these bans here, Headhunter?
Yeah, like we were talking about that Gladiator ban, that's a big one. Other ones seem pretty common, seeing Bombardier, Soulstealer bans, you know, common heroes, people, tons of people good at Soulstealer and able to really dominate games with that. Bombardier, another hero who's really, really utility, really good utility to have on your team. No bans really that unexpected, honestly. I don't know, Thunderbringer, a great hero for tri-lanes and to counter tri-lanes, so another hero that you would expect to see a ban.
Yeah, really nothing too crazy, you know what I mean? With bans. I mean, you know, Swiftblade, SK Gaming, they're known to play him quite a bit, so nothing interesting there. It's pretty odd. We do have a couple of those. You know, Swiftblade's kind of equivalent to Gladiator, obviously not a ban-worthy hero, but when you're facing Fnatic MSI, he definitely is. Kind of the same thing for Swiftblade against SK Gaming. So, yeah, I mean, really nothing much else to mention about the bans, though, because they are pretty obvious, pretty, you know, very standard, other than maybe a couple of those, which we went over. Now, the picking stage, interesting, very interesting. Fnatic MSI, yeah. They first pick Voodoo Jester, you know, not really a big surprise by any means. Great support, hero, excellent for trialing strategy, but Soul Reaper to follow it up. How about that?
I don't know. Like, honestly, with heroes like Witch Slayer and Glacius still on the board, you don't really expect to see a Soul Reaper that early, especially, and I don't know. They must have some crazy strategy planned already. Ready to pull it out and do some interesting tri-lane maybe, because those two heroes definitely could work in a tri-lane. I could see a Soul Reaper even maybe trying to go for some sort of long lane strategy.
Yeah, you know, Soul Reaper, the thing with him, obviously, you know, he can technically play Babysit because he has a heal ability, but more than likely you will be seeing him either in a solo or, if anything, a two-man lane. To be part of a trial lane just would not be expected. He definitely has that intellect carry potential. If he can get very tanky, he can definitely be in the midst of those team fights. His R does a lot of damage. It adds up, obviously, and just spamming that heal ability. And then, of course, his ultimate is great for nuking play. What the? Wow! Wow! Did that just really happen? Did they just misclick or something? Are you kidding me?
I don't know. I don't know what just happened, but I'm pretty sure we're about to see a Wild Soul in the grand finals of the World Cup.
Wow.
and three support and three other support heroes.
This
all with
push.
Heal.
We are going to see massive push. That is the only explanation. Either that, or we're going to see a level one Conqueror attempt. But there's no way that SK Gaming will let them do that. There's absolutely no way. So I believe MSI, they're going to go for a crazy push strategy here. They got the tri healer setup, something we have not seen in literally it has to be 6 months or so. I just can't believe we're actually seeing a tri heal setup from Fnatic MSI here, and then a Wild Soul push. It's the absolutely only thing I can think of here. We are not going to see a laning phase. We are going to see a very aggressive push.
Absolutely, yeah. I'm just interested to see what their last hero is going to be like. You think they're going to pick up another hero for their tri lane? Or do you think they're going to run like a 2-1 jungle and then another solo? Like you'd think Wild Soul would jungle, but like with
tri lane
so common now, jungling is hard.
Look at that.
There we go.
It's obvious. I mean, they're going to look to just crazy push some towers here, and things just got really interesting as a result. Obviously, SK Gaming, they do realize that what is going on, but so they finish with Poliwag Priest. Again, now this is the thing. I don't know. Is MSI, are they going to go for a tri lane? Are they going to maybe do a Wild Soul tri lane and then have Poliwag and Soul Reaper solo and then try to make something happen and they'll maybe get levels at least, maybe level 6, and then look to push? Or are they? I wouldn't be surprised if they send all 5 in a lane, honestly, and just push a tower in.
I mean, it's possible with that lineup, absolutely. But, I mean, Poliwag and Soul Reaper, both heroes that are capable of soloing. So, we could see a Wild Soul jungle and then, like, a Voodoo Accursed lane, possibly, to try and counter a tri lane if SK decides to go with that. Because, like, that's where it's really interesting is, what's SK going to do to respond to such a weird, like, setup from MSI?
Oh, yeah. I mean, 100%. Obviously, we've been focusing on MSI here for very obvious reasons, because they're just crazy lineup. I mean, talk about busting out the big guns. It's funny we see this on MSI's part, because SK Gaming, they both going into the EG game, and now even this one, Beatus has stated that they have tricks up their sleeves. They are going to, you know, come up with different strategies that will catch the other team off guard. MSI never really said anything about that, but, I mean, MSI has always been labeled as the one line team. They always run the same strategy, very similar, tri-lane gladiator or whatever, and they win because of that. This is nothing like a tri-lane gladiator. This is completely different, so anyone that labels them with that name after this, you know, shame on you. But let's go over SK Gaming's lineup, though. So we've been enough on MSI. Quickly, SK Gaming's lineup, so they went with Hellbringer, Bubbles, Flint Beastwood, Myrmidon, and Behemoth. I love that Myrmidon-Behemoth combination. Of course, very, very, very powerful. We've seen it so many times lately. Just that double really fissure stun ability between the Weed Field and the fissure from Behemoth is so hard to avoid, let alone get away from.
That combo is ridiculous and is so hard to stop. This is so weird. I don't even know what to say. It looks like Wild Soul will be long laning, maybe?
Well, he's right now up in the jungle on the short lane.
Short lane, which was...
Well, okay, here's...
I mean...
Go ahead.
No, it looks like SK is just going to go for that Myrmidon Behemoth with Flint Beastwood tri-lane that you were talking about, and I just think it's going to be interesting to see how Wild Soul is going to go up against the tri-lane. I mean, you can see him having a slight advantage over some other heroes because he can jungle with his bear while he's in the tri-lane or use his bear to try and just get last hits and experience. So either way, Wild Soul is going to be at an advantage to some other heroes because he's going to actually have some means to get last hits and experience even when he's in a 1v3 situation.
Freshbro has stated several times, and I don't know if it was a build-up for this purpose right here, but he has stated that he has been playing, you know, Wild Soul occasionally in public games and whatnot, and he has always talked about Wild Soul as being a very likable hero of his, so it is kind of cool that we finally get to see Wild Soul being played by him. And like you said, I mean, having that bear, and it's 1v3, technically it's kind of 2v3, though, because especially with a bear, you don't need to obviously, you don't want him to die and get the gold bounty to the Legion team after we wait for the cooldown, But it, you see right there, he just teleports it back to him with the cooldown used right there. And, you know, he's more than fine if he does get in a dangerous situation. But he's able to put him in some places that you normally wouldn't want to go as a melee hero and get those creep kills in there. So Fresh Bro, he already does have, you know, only two creep kills, but hey, it's at least something, especially for being in a 1v3 lane. Let's take a look at the other lanes now. We got, so it's Poliwag Priest matched up against Hellbringer. Curse is currently doing a little bit of roaming. He was hanging out in the middle lane for a little bit, but now headed towards the top side. And that leaves Bubbles to go solo against a Voodoo Jester Soul Reaper. Absolute. I mean, Trafalmador, he's just in an awful spot down there. That's just a very, very hard lane to go up against. Just spammable heals, obviously. And then just a constant push and constant creep kills for them. And Trafalmador is just going to have to hug this tower really as much as possible. He is managing to get some levels, as expected. I mean, definitely not necessarily a dangerous lane in terms of hero kills, but it is a very harassment heavy lane, and he will have some trouble because of that. But as long as he can stay near the tower somewhat, get at least the levels, you know, he shouldn't do that bad. But Poliwag Priest is going to go down to this bottom rune and bottle it up. Was there action?
No, I was just going to say, yeah, Bubbles, especially in good hands, is going to be able to not really get killed in a lane. He might get harassed, but if he uses his take cover right, he's not going to be able to get... He's going to dodge Voodoo Jester stuns, and he's really going to be able to survive and do a good job in this. We do see Accursed heading top for MSI, so maybe MSI deciding that they need more than one hero against this lineup. But we do see Behemoth heading mid at the same time, so lots of movement from both teams. Both teams probably trying to set up some kills and some ganks. We could see middle go down here. Yeah, Poliwag getting blocked and Hellbringer going in on him. But Poliwag using his metam. Yeah, he goes down. No reason to even say what he did. He just went down really fast. Smackdown even. I don't know. I feel like he could have avoided that. They do have wards everywhere. And yeah, I feel like he could have avoided going down like that. Do you think that was something that should have happened there?
Well, like you said, they do have wards everywhere, but unfortunately they're at the bottom lane. They don't have any sight at the top side, so it pretty much came down to it. They would have had to have him missing an action call, which is possible. You know, I'm sure Wilds will at least mention something of it, but at the same time, you can't necessarily play fully passive. He wasn't really playing too aggressive. I mean, he was on his ramp. It just so happened. In fact, right here, once again, another trap on a Poliwag Priest.
Oh,
in comes Hellbringer, applying the pressure. He's just going to be able to squeak around, however, not completely blocked off, and he will be able to get away this time, but Behemoth is making sure No-Tail, playing this Poliwag Priest, is not able to get any free... You know, he's in his head. It's a mind game now, and now Poliwag Priest will perhaps play a little bit more passive because he has to keep in the back of his head that Behemoth may be nearby looking to line up yet another Fissure Stun, and that caused a lot of pressure, if not kill me. So you see him right here, Hellbringer pushed all the way up. I mean, Poliwag Priest sitting on the top of his ramp, falling all the way back to his tower now. However, a curse coming over here. Behemoth running into a curse. Behemoth has a haste rune activated. Not going to do too much with it, but of course, Poliwag and a curse know that he is here, and they are playing pretty much hugging the tower at this point as a result. Bubbles is headed over. Is he going to look to maybe initiate? But again, with them hugging the tower, they can't expect too much to happen unless they try to go for a quick kill, say, on this Accursed. But it's going to be interesting. I mean, Bubbles is thinking about it. He is running right next to this ward of sight, though, so of course he is spotted. Meanwhile, at the top lane, Watsall kind of getting caught right here. The Wayfield coming out, not going to hit him. He is able to dodge it, actually, spawning his bear right there and going to be able to make the distance. He doesn't have boots. Actually, look at that. He transfers the boots from his bear to himself, so he gets the extra speed. Very smart play from Freshman. But what a block from Behemoth right there. And Watsall's in a lot of trouble now. He is not going to be able to get away. And down goes Wildsoul. Angry Testy with the hero kill, but Card definitely deserving a lot of credit early on in this game for SK Gaming.
Yeah, that's just the beauty of Behemoth. That hero can roam so well, and that Fissure is probably, I would say, one of the most effective like early game kill mechanisms in the game of Han, just because it's so strong early game and can block a hero off completely if you use it right. Just like we saw there, Wildsoul had nowhere to go, and there was no chance of him escaping once that Fissure went.
Yeah, I mean, a roaming Behemoth, definitely one of the most dangerous roamers in the game because of that Fissure stun. He doesn't need to get right next to you to obviously cause a stun to happen. He could just be hiding in the woods like he has been and completely catch you literally out of the woods. And you just it's very, very difficult to react to it. Cursed has been hugging Poliwag Priest a little bit more, but Behemoth coming in from behind once again as Hellbringer gets initiated on. Behemoth with the Fissure stun, though, blocking him off. There goes the Malphus ultimate coming out, and Bubbles joins the party as well. What a shield from a Cursed, though, Padua and the cauterize. He is still alive. Behemoth does not have enough mana for another stun, so we will not be able to cut him off. Acid Cocktail coming in from Voodoo Jester. And a Mojo thrown on Padua Priest. Unbelievable. What support right there from the Hellborn team, but that is the power of having Tri-Heal on your team.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Poliwag able to survive a seemingly impossible situation. Even with that Hellbringer ult going off, which I don't think MSI really expected to happen. I'm not sure they knew that he had the ult ready, and they were still able to get out with no deaths. So they're really showing the power of this interesting lineup.
Yeah, you know, it really is funny, because obviously Push was the name of the game. You see their lineup. Push is just really the first thing that pops in your head. They haven't really been aggressively pushing anywhere yet, but again, I think it might be they're waiting for the levels, at least, though, around level 6. Padawak just hit level 6, so, of course, he's got his wars now, and maybe this is where we'll start to see, perhaps, a little bit more aggressive push-style strategy as a result of him getting that, but, you know, for now, still no push going on just yet, not anything overly aggressive. For right now, just playing the laning phase as it is, and trying to make their best with that, while still currently it back in the jungle. You know, that's, again, another great thing that he can go from the lane to the jungle pretty much at ease. You see his items.
Exactly.
He has boosts. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say that sets him up to really have an advantage over other heroes in a 1v3 setup against the tri-lane, just because other heroes can't just go to the jungle anytime they want and kill some creeps, but Wild Soul doesn't even need to be able to pull or anything. He can just go there and kill creeps at will, and that gives him a huge advantage. He's really keeping up with levels. He's level 5, whereas the three heroes he's against are 5, 5, and 3, so, I mean, I'd say that's a pretty good job by him for keeping up with levels.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. I mean, only 14 creep kills, but yeah, levels are... If you're kind of not going to get the creep square, might as well at least get levels in. He is definitely hanging
exactly
in there with that. We do have a little bit of a run-in right here. Myrmidon running into Voodoo Duster. Acid Cocktail coming out. The cauterize to nuke him down a little bit, but the waveform going to be used. And Myrmidon's going to be more than fine in terms of getting out of there. So pressure a little bit being applied. But Invisrium bottled up by Poliwag Priest in the meantime. Hellbringer does not have his ultimate currently. Now another 15 seconds before it will be off cooldown. But of course he will have it very shortly as a result. Soul Reaper has been having a good time at this bottom lane. His creep score, I'm guessing, at Trixie, 47 and 17. That is actually the top creep score in the game. And at 302 gold per minute, the top on the team, very close to Flint Beastwood, who's actually the top in the game right now. We do have a little bit of action in the middle lane. One's coming out, but there's that Hellbringer ultimate. Flint Beastwood porting in, throwing out his flare, and Behemoth with the finish done, blocking off Flint Beastwood, however, and that's, you know, you live and die by the fissure. Hellbringer did end up going down to the wards, as you can see, but what I mean by that is it can set up some great ganks, but it can also cause us some issues, as we saw right there, as Flint Beastwood did get cut off, his pathing got mistaken, and was not able to keep on initiating onto Poliwag Priest.
We do see bubbles going down bottom, and now Myrmidon coming in, though, to teach Soul Reaper a lesson. Soul Reaper able to heal and try and get away, but I'm pretty sure he's going to get taken out. Hellbringer coming around, and Soul Reaper in trouble. Behemoth also coming down. Yeah, Soul Reaper, if MSI does this, or SK does this right, Soul Reaper should.
It is Soul Reaper, though. But he is tanky. Like, nope.
Nope.
Almost enough.
That was close, yeah. I'm actually surprised he got that far. I feel like SK should have reacted a little faster and gotten down there quicker, and they could have guaranteed that kill a little more than they did, since that was the last tick of Death Boil that got that Soul Reaper.
Yeah, I mean, he is a very hard hero to kill, especially, you know, with the early farm he has. He has the Steam Boots and the Ring of the Teacher early on, so, again, with the heal that he has, he can definitely keep himself regenerated and not too easy to take down, but right there, the dot was just able to be enough. Another rune bottled up here by No-Tail playing Poliwag Priest. He definitely seems like he's had pretty much the majority of the rune control throughout this game, if not all of them, in fact. Of course, haven't kept
them
on every single
one. I don't think I've seen anyone else get...
Yeah, he's been doing a good job, as always. I mean, it is No-Tail after all. Poliwag Priest is not necessarily a hero we're used to seeing him play, but it is a solo mid-hero, and he is definitely one of the best, if not the best, arguably, the solo player in the world. So, doing a fantastic job, really, as expected. there in the middle lane. Swiper, though, goes, you know, after that death, you know, Trixie, typical Trixie fashion, he goes right back to the lane and continues to push it once again, continues to get his farm on. He is not going to let anything faze him. Looks like there's a little bit of action here at the top side. In fact, Hellbringer gets caught by the bear right here with the entangle. Kind of dropped about half life, but he's going to be more than fine. You see the shield throwing onto Watson. Another entangle. Gotta love their RNG right there. Kelfu going to be used by Puddles. He wants to save his teammate. Wow, Hellbringer dropping really low. Oh, not. Can he get another entangle proc? That would just be amazing. But no, Buried Along going to be teleported right back to Wild Soul, and they're going to run away, but the pressure being shown, RNG coming into play. Poliwag Priest, however, in the meantime, did go down to Flint Beastwood and Myrmidon there to assist.
Yeah, now that entangle, another thing we didn't really talk about with Wild Soul, that entangle is super strong. It's a huge disable that has not that low of a proc chance, honestly. And it looks like Voo Jester getting initiated on, but he is going to survive even with that Flint Beastwood ult going out on.
Behemoth has been here in the bottom lane by himself, going one versus one against Swiper for a little bit. Actually, landing a Fissure Stone right there as Hellbringer pointing in. Going to use a Malphite's ultimate. They really want this kill right here. In fact, though, Swiper, I'm not sure if I'm a fan of that ultimate from Fogged. It is a very long cooldown. They are going to be able to push the lane back a little bit, I guess, from using it. But there was no way they were going to catch Swiper right there with just them two, especially after the Fissure Stone was already used.
Yeah, Swiper just, I mean, he's a super tanky hero even early. Especially with that heal up to level 4 now, it's just really going to be strong. Looks like we do see a Hellborn tower kill popping that Poliwag ult. One of the beauties of their pushing team is that Poliwag ult. That's just going to be able to destroy towers so fast, especially with the healing support that allows the heroes to stay near the tower and keep attacking it in addition to the ward.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely the what we were talking about early on in the pregame, really, after seeing the picks, the push potential. So, although MSI hasn't been maybe as crazy with it as me. Oh, well, nice trap! Look at that! The X, or the V is formed! The Wayfield and the Fissure Stone form a V pretty much right on top of Swiper. He had absolutely no chance of getting out of there, and down he wins. So, excellent job right there from the Legion team, setting up that kill on Swiper, being played by Trixie. That's just the power of the double range stun that both Myrmidon and Behemoth, of course, have. They're going to try to make a little bit of a tower push themselves. They say, we might not have the team makeup that you guys do, but we can still push them damn towers in, and already applying a good amount of pressure to this bottom one. Will the Hellborn team react quick enough is the question now. Accursed is starting to walk over there. I'm guessing Soul Reaper will port here as soon as he resurrects, which is in about 2 seconds. So, yeah, the push is going to fall back now from the Legion team, and it looks like they are going to be done with it. But so, yeah, going back to that tower push at top, though, the wards were used by Poliwag Priest. Every single cooldown now, honestly, from Poliwag Priest. In fact, we see right here, 10 seconds left on it. They're already going to go to initiate on this middle tower. Wild Soul leading the way with that bear. It does extra damage to the towers now, of course. The trap, though, on a Poliwag Priest from the Wayfield. A new coming in for Bubbles, taking out Poliwag Priest right there. The Kelfo trapping Voodoo Jester a little bit. Not going to be nearly enough, though. He's going to come in, throw an acid cocktail. Wants to save Wild Soul. The dot is taken, though. The dot is taken, and down goes Wild Soul. Port coming in from Accursed. He gets trapped immediately, though, as soon as he ports in. And the Legion team is actually just falls back. They want to save this tower. They are going to deny it, it looks like. So the tower will end up falling. Going to be denied, however, but I think it's safe to say that that fight was won by SK Gaming.
Absolutely. I mean, that fight was won, and they got the deny, so they won even more than just, like, winning in hero kills there. And that's really showing the power of this SK team. I know you've been talking a ton about MSI's team, but SK's team just has ridiculous team fighting ability with the Behemoth, especially with his ult, which hasn't even really started to come into play yet, but just the disables from Myrmidon and Behemoth combined with the Bubbles ult, which is AoE, the Hellbringer ult, which is AoE, and yeah, I just think it's going to be really hard for MSI to do anything in a really big, in like a 5v5 team fighting situation.
Yeah, it is. It definitely is. I can agree with you there. Obviously, when it comes to the Legion team and team fights, the Hellbringer Behemoth combination right there alone is very, very powerful. And Flint Beastwood, as always, he's great at sitting back in those fights and just pounding into the team. You see Bairdalon right here actually attracting not only the creep wave, but the heroes. He just runs right by them. No CC put on him. He's just, you know, staying in range and really kind of wandering off the Legion team from the defensive tower. So actually, a very good use of Bairdalon right there, as it did take away the creep
totally
wave.
Stopping that.
Yeah, it really did just stop that push right there because the creep wave followed it too. So very, very, again, as we talked about earlier, not a hero that we see often, but Freshro, he does have a decent history of playing him in, you know, public games and, you know, less competitive games perhaps, and showing that right here. The defensive tower is starting to drop, though, trying to deny with Barrier Line. Not going to happen, however. And the Hellborn team, as we're talking about, they wouldn't dare look to initiate in a big team fight like that. They just do not have the advantage when it comes to initiation. But they do have the heal. They do have heal power. So it will be...
Yeah, that's what I think is going to give them...
Yeah.
Is the heal
power. Yeah, the tri-heal that they have, that we've seen it several times. Again, it's been a long time since we've really seen it, but when we have seen it really in the past, that is a huge benefit of Viscogorce. You think someone's just going to drop, and all of a sudden three heals come out, and he's just back to full life, so...
Yeah, just like what we saw on that that Poliwog Priest earlier in the game when he was about to die and just all the heals came out and he didn't even... We do see some action.
Oh, Hellbringer Ultimate's going to be used right there, trying to scare them off. The tower actually gets denied by the Legion team. Poliwog Priest with a tongue-tied onto Behemoth right there, trying to keep him in place. Close enough. Electric Jolt coming out, and yes, it is going to be enough for the kill onto Behemoth. It looks like the Aura, in fact, ticked him down from Soul Reaper. Bobble's porting in, throwing out a Kelp Field, catching a couple of players, but we are seeing the healing potential. Look at that. No one actually dying throughout that fight, and enough heals were used right there by the Hellborn side to keep everyone alive. We do see Incursus, in fact, I wanted to mention this earlier. He actually didn't get his ultimate. He chose to He's just maxing out both Fire Shield and Cauterize, playing pure support. He doesn't care about activating that ultimate for himself at this point. He just wants to maximize his healing potential, which he definitely, I'm sure, helped right there throughout that fight. So only one player dying, from what I recall, I believe it was Behemoth, the only player to die there for the Legion team. And they were able to deny the tower, excuse me, at least. But an aggressive push from MSI, and well, they're keeping their name up there with their push strategy of the team makeup that they have now, leading 3-1 in tower kills, and already applying a little bit of pressure at least at this top tower secondary one. This is pretty much around half life at this point.
Yeah, I mean, even like earlier there was a fight going down bottom, and Poliwog was just using his ult to solo push alone on that top tower, and that's why it's so low right now, because he was just able to be there with his ult and get that tower that low alone. And I don't see any way SK is going to be able to win the pushing game early game. And I think their real strength will come if they can stall out long enough and have enough farm late game to really counteract this pushing from MSI.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you 100%. Simply because it comes down to Flint Beastwood. Obviously, when you compare hard carries, Wild Soul definitely has hard carry potential, and he can take over games. However, he is going to be a little bit behind in levels because the Hellborn team, because of their setup, they will stick together a lot more than the Legion team when they're doing the tower pushes or whatnot, and obviously that does nerf your experience, and we are seeing a little bit of a gap right here. In fact, a level 10 Flint Beastwood, who's halfway through compared to a Wild Soul, who's level 8 just over the halfway mark, so already we are seeing that slight level advantage in favor of Flint Beastwood. And speaking of Flint Beastwood, he has an 18 and a half minute Geometer's Bane, farming 358
wow.
gold per minute, being played by Angry Testy. I guess you really shouldn't be too shocked, but yeah, that is huge for SK Gaming already having that item. And again, if SK Gaming can get involved in a team fight with Flint Beastwood sitting in the background just pounding out his damage, it's going to be difficult for this Hellborn team to execute what they want to execute.
One other thing to note, actually, is that we were talking about that Wild Soul being behind in the carry field, but we do know that Soul Reaper can also carry, and it doesn't look like he's going to go for that kind of a build, though. He did get the Steam Boots, but that's common on a healing Soul Reaper as well, and then he's picking up that Astrolabe, so I don't really see him going for that really a carry setup, you know what I mean?
Yes and no. I mean, Astrolabe definitely is a great support item, obviously, because it has that AoE heal, and for a push-style strategy, I mean, it's you pretty much need an Astrolabe. It's just a given when you're running a strategy like this. However, it does also apply, you know, the armor to him as well as in the aura effect, and you get some nice stats from it. So I still think he could definitely still go for a tanky-style build if he chooses to do four, but here we go. Initiation going to be happening. Wayfield going to try to cut them off a little bit right there, stunning them shortly, but of course, the heal's coming out, and right back goes the Hellborn's life. Tower. Priest Ward's, of course, going to be spawned right here. The bear tanking the tower out in front. The shield put on him. The tower easily dropping right there. Absolutely no chance for the Legion team to defend that half-down tower at that point. And instead of initiating, they just decide really to let it fall. And we'll clean up the creep wave. The Hellworn team, of course, again, that their game is not to get involved in team fights. Their game is to push down towers and then fall back and keep the pressure up elsewhere. They do not want to, you know, charge into these team fights. So they do fall back smartly. And the Legion team, now, this is where it gets interesting. Are they going to counteract with the push themselves? And it looks like they are. They are starting to push back the top tower, cleaning up the creep wave as fast as possible. And they're going to start putting damage up here. So with the Hellborn team, oh, look at this, though. Instead of defending the tower, they say, you know what? You go ahead and be occupied with the tower. We're going to go for a quick conger kill. Do they have the damage, though, is the question. Sure, they can tank it as for hours, but do they have enough damage and quick enough? Legion team, they have a ward of sight down here. I don't believe that's enough vision, though, spotting all the way to the conger pit. Legion team, they are porting down there, though, so they know what's going on. The Hellborn team, it's going to be a race. Now, again, they do not have much damage. This is going to be interesting. We see, oh, what a cutoff right there on a Soul Reaper with the Fissure Shot. Money shot on Soul Reaper. He's dropping fast. He is taking a lot of occupancy, though, with the Legion team going out. And meanwhile, back here, we see Tongue Tied on the Hellbringer. Wayfield going to keep him out, though. Hellbringer ultimate coming out. The Legion team wants something out of this. Angry Tessie ends up killing Trixie in the meantime off to the right. So Soul Reaper does go down. Conqueror still about 3,000 life nearly, and now we're going to have a game of chicken right here. Who's going to blink in first, and who's going to go for that actual conger kill? But Legion team reacts fast enough, how about that, and they prevent the conger kill from going through.
That was well done by them. They got that tower, and they were managed to prevent the conger kill even without Behemoth there, like, because Behemoth wasn't pushing with them, and I was going to note that, but apparently it ended up being good, and they're actually going to get middle tower as well. So SK able to almost come back in the tower game. They're behind by, what, one tower now. So SK able to, I think this is showing, giving SK an advantage now. If you look at the experience in the gold, up by 3,000 experience and 3,500 gold, and now evening up the towers almost. I don't know. I see MSI's strategy only getting weaker from this point as well. I don't really see, like, this is the peak. The mid game is the peak of their strategy.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. I mean, this is it. So, if anything, this is going to determine right here. And, in fact, it looks like, wow, they actually are going to come back and get the conger kill. Legion team, they all fell back. They went and bought their items. They did some regen. But so MSI, you know, as smart as they are, they figured that was what was going on. And why not go for to finish off conger right there? Sure enough, they do. And Soul Reaper is actually the one to pick it up. So, kind of, you know, helps you Legion believe that perhaps they want him to survive and stay strong in these team fights. He is level 12. The highest level in the whole game, in fact. So, yeah, he is their go-to guy, as Trixie usually is, honestly. And he is, once again, going to lead the way right here. And here we go with another tower push. Polywar Priest Wars, they are off cooldown, of course. Seem to be placed, I'm sure, any second right now. Wayfield coming out, harass them a little bit. But there goes the wards off to the side. Perfect angle right there, kind of hidden in the jungle. You see Hellbringer, though, doing a good job in both Flint Piece as well. They're actually picking off the wards very quickly. But a Baradalon also doing a bit of damage. But Kelfield going to be used right here. Will the Legion team react to this? Out come the Wayfield. Going to miss completely, though. Behemoth ultimate right on top. Soul Reaper dropping fast. He is drained of his mana. Down he goes. He will resurrect, though, with the token of life. And here we go. Are they going to make a comeback right here? Soul Reaper still tanking the damage. We do see Hellbringer going down. Behemoth trying to port out. Will be successful as we see the two bad message come out. And here we go. Flint Piece of pounding into Voodoo Jester. But again, the heals, they're just so powerful on the side of the Hellborn team. Other than Soul Reaper just getting dropped instantly, resurrecting with the token alive, coming right back up, out go the heals, and they are probably going to finish this tower. Baradalon is just about dead. You see Freshbro, though, he keeps on spawning it backwards to take the aggro off of him. They get the tower kill, and they will fall back. Execution at its finest from Fnatic MSI.
Yeah, absolutely. That they are definitely taking advantage of that token. I honestly think the token is what won them that fight, because without Soul Reaper there, that loses them 130 damage heal every 5 seconds. And without that, I feel like they're in huge trouble in those fights.
Yeah, I mean, SK Gaming, obviously, I don't think they need to be in panic mode by any means, because, again, we're talking about the whole strategy and how, really, this is the time to shine for Fnatic MSI, so it's kind of expected that they are getting these tower kills like they are. But at the same time, SK Gaming, you know, there has to be that little bit of a worrisome in the back of their mind, of course. They do have that portal key on Behemoth, a very important item, obviously. Bubbles, I'm curious if he's still working on his If he chooses to go Portal Key, that's around 1,700-1,800 gold saved up. So like probably is. 2,200 gold currently saved up on Flint Beast one now. So will he go, you know, Frost of Skull route? Very popular item on him, obviously, after the Geometer's Bane. And then a Hellbringer doing his support thing. He actually has a Puzzle Box level 1 currently. Going to try to help with that. And, of course, getting that level 3 will be very powerful. Indeed. Mirabadon being the ward bitch. No surprise there. Being played by B-Diz. Not too much of a farm, but getting the job done at least from what he can. Right now, it's we talked about earlier, Flint Beastwood is the key to this Legion team, really. Sure, Initiation is great from Behemoth and Hellbringer, obviously, and they all need that, but Flint Beastwood, it's going to be a farming game at this point. They need him to out-farm the whole Hellborn side and just be able to sit back in those fights like he kind of did last fight and just pick people off.
Absolutely. It looks like Sword Reaper picking up that gnome, so I think Sword Reaper's just going to use the inherent like tank ability of Soul of his hero to really do the carrying in that sense and not really go for any carry-based items.
Well, if anything, with a build like this, says, oh my god, look at this. He's actually charges in right here onto Flint Beastwood. Wow. Again, he's showing that she just isn't scared whatsoever. Flint Beastwood is going to be able to port away right here unless we see an ultimate. No, he gets away. So, but he's showing right there that he's got some balls and not afraid to initiate. We do have, it looks like Behemoth actually got caught right there by Wild Soul. Wild Soul with a double damage rune activated, able to pick him off. But, yeah, I mean, again, going back to Soul Reaper, at this point, I'm Intellect Heavy is definitely going to be a build for him, and I would think Frostfield Plate at this point would be a very beneficial pickup, because obviously it gives you not only the Intellect bigger mana pool, but it gives you the armor, which is great against Flint Beast, who we've been referring to, and then also that effect built in itself with the AoE slow. So definitely feel a Frostfield Plate would be a very, very smart and ideal pickup with the way this game has been going for them. But another tower pushed in. This time the Legion team just really didn't even react to it. Hellbringer was busy pushing the middle lane in, and with Behemoth being dead, I guess they just thought it would better of themselves to not do it. Ring of the Sorcery, that was the other item I was going to talk about with the push-style strategy and heal-style strategy, whatever you want to call it. And indeed, they do pick that up on a curse. Here we go. Once again, Ward's going to be used. Flint Beastwood immediately picks them off, though, as fast as possible. And actually, They just drop like they weren't even there. But damage is definitely still being done. Of course, Bairdalon going to be ported back before he's actually killed. But the tower already down to half-life.
Yeah, MSI's pushing ability is just amazing with this team lineup. And I agree with you. Behemoth being down was what made Legion not want to initiate. I'm actually pretty surprised they didn't go for more of an initiation after that, during that MSI pushing attack. Because Behemoth's ult's up, and with that portal key, he can really set up the rest of their team to go to Hellbringer with such a long-range ult, sets up the Behemoth, then Bubbles can come in and hold all those heroes together longer. And, I mean, I just can't even get over how much synergy the Legion team has in teamfights. Here's a Behemoth ult, and Bubbles coming in. Exactly what I just said happened. Bubbles and Behemoth using their ults together to get two kills straight.
I do apologize. I actually missed that real quickly, but as you saw right there, the power of the portal key coming into play. Akura's going to activate his ultimate. He is purged, however, from the Nullfire Blade, and here we go. They're going to follow it up. Akura's maybe picked off right here, and TD is. And how about that? Nullfire Blade picked up by Flint Beastwood. Very, very smart pickup. Of course, it gets rid of all those buffs on them, and the ideal one more than likely being the shield, if not the accursed ultimate, as we saw right there. So they're going to start pressuring the tower. They take out the tower themselves. And as you talked about earlier, they honestly aren't too far behind in the tower stage, so that really isn't that big of a deal in that stint. They are down by one tower at this point. They're going to look to push in the middle tower, however. Accursed and Polywog Priest will be resurrecting in the next 10 seconds or so. So will the Legion team actually stick around? They do not have a Behemoth ultimate. They do have a Hellbringer ultimate, however. Tower dropping fast. Polywog Priest porting in right here. And it looks like that is enough for the Legion team to spread out and then start to run away. But because of the spread, they are very vulnerable to getting caught in this at the same time. In fact, a cancel port right there by Flint Beastwood. He is panic mode right now. We do see the double damage bottle right up in front of him. Going to use an Nullfire Blade onto the bear right there. He does not want to get entangled. Make sure to slow him. But look at how fast Wild Soul is. Basically has a haste rune activated at all times right now. He's chasing down this Flint Beastwood. Can the bear get close enough to entangle him? Will they get an entangle proc with this? No, again, the Nullfire use. So he's making him use charges at least. But again, he is not able to finish off Flint Beastwood. But like I said, two charges were used right there to slow down the bear, and you know those charges only has five left now, and like I said, using it for different things, he definitely does not want to have to use it for that.
Definitely. And that SK really playing smart there and backing off at the exact right time, none of them going down. If they had stayed there even a second longer, multiple heroes on their team could have got picked off, but they really left at the exact time they should.
Speaking of more farm, Soul Reaper actually picks up a Shaman's Headdress, so he's more concerned about that magic damage and those AoE fights, and every right to be, obviously, between
Hellbreaker
and Bubbles.
Barrier, right?
Yeah, no doubt, actually, when you think about it. Yeah, so he is going there really very classy support build for the heal team that they have. You see the Plated Greaves, of course, on a curse as well to help with that. Voodoo Jester, as we talked about Myrmidon, he is the ward bitch, so no surprise with his items. He's got a boots and a mana battery, but been taking care of the wards, buying those homecoming stones. Somebody usually has to sacrifice, and as it always is really for MSI, Nova taking care of that role.
Well, the thing about Voodoo Jester, too, is he's really able to do that, because all Voodoo Jester needs is his ultimate, and as long as he isn't too far behind in levels, he can still be very effective, even with basically no item.
Oh, yeah, 100%. I mean, the Acid Cocktail itself as well. I mean, his ability, he's one of those heroes.
Right, yeah.
Similar to Glacius, obviously, where doesn't necessarily need, as long as he gets a certain amount of levels, be somewhat useful. Look at this, Bairdlon is, I was looking at the other thing. Okay, that's why. Anyways, I thought his life was, like, almost dead, but on my screen, because the top bar is, like, black, but I guess that's his mana pool or something. Something else. There's energy bar, I guess.
No, I see that too. I don't even know what that is, because Bairdlon is not on a timer, is he? So I'm not really sure what that bar.
I'm not 100%. I think it is some type of timer, maybe for like to teleport him back, and if you don't have any of that, then you can't. I don't know. Anyways.
Bubbles looks to be going for a null stone. He has picked up a Blessed Orb counter warding right now.
Yeah. I mean, null stone or sheepstick.
True.
I kind of feel Sheepstick would probably make a little bit more sense in this case, but I mean, also definitely has its good effects too, so we'll see which route Bubbles is. Of course, Sheepstick is quite expensive for that 2,700 gold for the Acolyte staff. Yeah. Penny Mage just
one
pinned.
Thing to note though, like, with the Sheepstick, like, the problem with Wild Soul is that he's basically two heroes in one, so who do you sheep? Do you stop the bear who can constantly disable your team, or do you stop Wild Soul who's really dishing out the main amount of the damage? But honestly, both of them dish out a lot of damage. Even that bear, not being as strong, still able to dish out a good deal of damage, so maybe Cauldron not as effective as it would be against someone like Flint Beastwood.
Yeah, I mean, that is a fair point, too. So, well, we'll see which route Bubbles decides to go for. Again, it could be one of those, maybe depending on how his farm just feels and will adjust accordingly, or he has something set in mind and wants to go straight for it. Congor is up, however, and this, of course, he has been, as expected, a very interesting part of this game. Of course, the first Congor kill did end up going in favor of the Hellborn team, but after a crazy team fight, that actually scared them off initially. Legion side, Polymorph Priest, by the way, picking up the Shrunken Head. So that'll help him, obviously, keep people locked down a little bit better in those team fights. Behemoth and Bubbles pushing up the bottom lane a little bit.
Do you think Shrunken Head was the best possible item for him to go for?
Well, I mean, again, obviously, for a Polymorph Priest to get a Shrunken Head, it's because he wants to be able to channel that Tongue Tide, really, is what it comes down to. And obviously, throughout these team fights, it's been more than likely a case of him feeling getting knocked out of those Tongue Tides, perhaps. There is also a lot of magic damage coming up from the Legion team. Between the several of the ultimates, Myrmidon, Bubbles, and then Flint Beastwood's Flare, even. So, I don't know. It was the best pickup? I don't know. You know, you could have thought something maybe
good
like
pickup,
a...
for sure.
Yeah, it was a good pickup. Definitely has its uses. But there are items like a Storm Spirit. Could be very beneficial. And eventually even something like a Sheepstick. Yeah.
But, I mean, I guess this Shrunken Head's basically doing the same thing as a Storm Spirit by allowing him to constantly disable someone without any worry of the disable being stopped. So, I mean, you could argue that it almost has more uses than a Storm Spirit in the right, like, hands, I guess.
Yeah, for sure. We do have a... Ooh, look at this. Hellbringer currently in Viz right on top of a couple of heroes right here. Scouting things out. He has his level 3 puzzle box finished. If he could, Legion team can get a really good opening right here with this great scout. that they have. Still have another 30 seconds or so on the Invis, so they do got plenty of time. You see Behemoth hanging off to the side. He is looking for that opportunity as well. Kind of runs away right now. Initiation happened. There we go. Polymer Priest jumps on a Flint Beast, so this would be a huge pick for them. But in the meantime, the Hellborn team is cut off by the Hellbringer Ultimate. Behemoth also doing his thing. Flint Beastwood, however, ends up getting taken. No, he's still alive, actually. He got away. Fissure Stunt from Behemoth helps him get away. The Polymer Priest wards are still up. Behemoth, what an ultimate! He jumped right back into that mix of the Hellborn players, and he ends up killing Polymer Priest in the process. He's going to try to port out. Oh! Are you kidding me? He gets out barely with any life. Flint Beastwood keeping his illusions there to do as much damage and drainage as possible. But wow, what a getaway by Behemoth. Literally a quarter of a second would have been dying. But that was an interesting fight because obviously it was a great lead right there for the Hellborn team. An excellent initiation onto Flint Beastwood, who seemed to be caught out by himself. But the Legion team reacted on the rest of the team, and somehow Flint managed to survive.
Yeah, absolutely. Just these heals from Hellborn, very effective. I feel like they're doing better in team fights than I thought they would be. I really thought that, especially with initiation like that, that they would lose a lot more heroes. But they're really showing the power of that, of the tri-heal, like we've been saying this whole time, how powerful it is. And with that Barrier Idol and Astrolabe now picked up by Sword Reaper, they just have so much support for the whole team that it's going to be really hard to take them out in a team fight, even with the power of the Legion team fighting capability.
Yeah, I mean, he is definitely getting a very tanky status with that Barrier Idol pickup, and in fact, another 1,800 gold already saved up. Conqueror being pinged right here. They are in the area, of course. Going to do a little bit of counter warding beforehand because definitely don't want to do it blind, obviously. Behemoth, the Fissure Stone, a trap air, Wild Soul right there. But going to end up running away. So a Hellborn team going to try to ninja another Conqueror. Legion team, they got to be very aware of what's going on, though. They don't necessarily have...
They do have the Poliwag illusions in the forest. Were able to spot the Legion team before they got here. So Hellborn definitely knows Legion's there, but I'm kind of surprised that SK isn't initiating faster. I really think MSI is confused as to what's going on and why the Legion isn't. And it looks like Hellborn's actually going to go in instead. Polywog popping that ult. Did he actually blink in there? Yeah, he did. And they take out Behemoth.
Yeah, still chasing Flint Beastwood, trying to run away. Going to once again use a no-fire to slow down. Baradalon does not want to get entangled. We see an initiation on the bubbles, and he gets nuked down. The Soul Reaper ultimate helping to execute him right there. And we see a spread from the Legion team just going to kind of panic right here. We see Myrmidon porting out. Shrunken Head going to be activated by Flint Beastwood, just trying to help him once again get away, as I believe he might have even got entangled right there by the bear. So using it to help him get away as Bubbles also came in there. So Hellborn team, like they did last time, really. They start on Conqueror. They end up getting whatever, falling back themselves after Team 5, but then they go right back into it, and they should be able to kill Conqueror quite easily now. Bubbles is nearby. May go for an epic ninja right here. That would be something. But I don't think they have really any vision on Conqueror specifically. Ooh, that was his opportunity right there, if any. But he doesn't go in time, and the token of life picked up on Wild Soul this time.
It looks like one thing to note, that was a really interesting choice by the Hellborn, honestly. Like, they're going for Conqueror, SK was standing there, and rather than either continue going for Conqueror or backing, they just decided to initiate right on SK, and I really think SK did not expect that at all, and that's what caused them to get caught so off guard that they were able to just lose that fight. Behemoth got melted so fast at the beginning that SK didn't really have a chance to react before they were already down one of their most important heroes for their team fight.
See a Thunderclaw picked up on Wild Soul, using it right there in the jungle, getting some more creep kills. This bear just has the boots, of course.
Wild Soul's getting pretty scary.
Yeah, I mean, he's actually getting very close to the 300 gold per minute mark. Another 1,800 gold saved off. Obviously, more than likely going to be going for the Warhammer. Bubbles almost runs into him, but realizes that he's up there, so it's probably best to start to run away at least. Hanging nearby somewhat.
Soul Reaper. Up to 400 gold per minute almost. Kind of ridiculous considering he's basically playing pure support. He's has the same gold per minute as the Flint Beastwood on the Legion. And honestly, you could look at that as almost a bad thing, since rather than Wild Soul having the same gold per minute, it's Soul Reaper who does, and I would argue that you definitely want more farmer in Wild Soul than you do on Soul Reaper.
It's tough to say, because honestly, Soul Reaper, he definitely can be a really scary character, and he's getting to that point. We see him picking up an Acolyte Staff. Obviously, it could either be a Sheepstick or a Frostfuel Plate, like I was referring to earlier in this case. I honestly think a Frostfuel Plate would really complete the style of hero that you ultimately wanted to be, in a very tanky hero that could just spam his abilities all day long. So we'll see which he decides to go for, though, but... yeah, but no doubt, Wild Soul, obviously. When it comes to DPS, when it comes to damage, direct damage, Wild Soul is going to be that type of hero. Polymar Priest jumps in right here, though, trying to catch actually Hellbringer, get him down before he gets his ultimate off, and yes, they're going to be successful with that. A huge pick off there for the Hellborn team, and once again, going to look to chase Wild Soul using the speed of his mirror, but not going to try to port out right here. Oh, the Entangle doesn't matter, though. He's able to Damn. Still port out and get away, so Wild Soul now still, once again, in pursuit. But, yeah, I wasn't sure if the Entangle would actually cancel. As you see, Fresh Pro thought it did, apparently. And I thought it did, too, to be honest. I thought it did a mini-stun, but I guess not.
I guess it's just an immobile.
Yeah, we can't see that. We can't look over the tooltip on the bear, unfortunately. Let's see exactly nope. What it is, but...
looks like MSI is going to take another tower here. Hellbringer is down, but Legion still has a lot of ability to try and hold MSI off. With that Behemoth ult and the Bubbles ult, they might be able to keep MSI off, but Bubbles ult still has a 30-second cooldown, so MSI really has a good timing window right now to take this tower down.
Oh yeah, without one of the two, either Hellbringer or Behemoth ultimate. See, this is the thing though, Behemoth, he's a great turtle hero for that purpose right there, throwing out the Fissure Stun. Here comes a little bit of initiation, Magikarp going to be used Bubbles with the Shell Surf, but just not enough damage at all to really scare off the Hellborn team. Yep. You see the shields and heals being put up. Once again, Polymar Priest jumps in, activates Dragon, and there's a Soul! Blah! The Behemoth ultimate though, on top of the Hellbringer ultimate. Soul Reaper is actually dropping really fast, and he indeed will go down. Myrmidon can take it out, but that is an exchange. The Legion team will take absolutely every single time. They are trying to chase now. Will they chase? Yes, they get the kill also on a Polywog Priest. So the power of the ultimates right there, starting with Behemoth on top of Hellbringers. And in fact, Behemoth now has this level 1 spell shards, so hoping a little bit more with that. A lot of AoE damage come out, crazy damage. So despite them being spam heal heavy, we're not able to keep both Soul Reaper and Polywog Priest up. So a good job right there by the Legion team. But the tower did get destroyed, so, you know, back and forth right there, as now the Legion racks are exposed.
It's better, yeah, it's better than... at least they took out the tower. I mean, SK's not really going to be able to capitalize on this opportunity, I don't think. They just don't have the mobility to get to the Legion base before Soul Reaper and Poliwag are going to respond. It looks like they're going to try and do some sort of counter push, but I feel like MSI will be able to hold this off long enough for Soul Reaper and Poliwag to come back. So I think MSI arguably came out on top there by being able to take out that tower. But they still did lose Soul Reaper, so I don't know. You could argue both ways for sure.
Yeah, he definitely could. Soul Reaper, though, at the same time, he's going to resurrect shortly, and he's going to have 1,800 gold saved up in his little piggy bank. So, again, more than fine. I'm curious what he does choose to go for. Personally think Frostfield Plate would be great on him, but of course Sheepstick definitely has its very effective use as well. You know, locking down someone like a Flimpy Swit, who does have a Shrunken Hand now, however. So that's the next item he went. There was an item that I wanted to talk about. Where was it? I guess Stormstreet picked up on a Cursed. Who did I want to talk about? Oh, yeah, the Geometer's been a while, so he had that going into that fight. Now picking up a Blessed Orb, so he's going to be going for the Frost of Skull as well. So he split up that Frostburn, obviously. And he's actually going to go to finish that before he even looks for a Charged Hammer at this point. And he still has a Token of Life, by the way, after that fight. So looking pretty good there. Again, they want him at this point in the game. It's about him really getting that farm to put out a lot of damage himself. As Soul Reaper is getting pretty much filled up himself in terms of his items. And obviously really only to just finish that Acolyte Staff and then pretty much be done with it.
Yeah. Looks like MSI wants this Rax, and they definitely have a good opportunity. Flimbeastwood is top, and he does have the Homecoming Stuns ready, though, so We might see a big team fight here. Behemoth ult up, Bubbles ult up, Hellburner ult about to be up. So I don't know if this is the best decision by MSI to go for these racks here. This could cost them a lot if they get genocided or a couple of their heroes get taken out.
This will determine quite a bit. We'll see what happens. A shield going to go out on a Sorcerer right there as soon as the Fissure Stun comes out. So again, the protection is right there between a Curse Fiend Jester and Soul Reaper. A Wild Soul leading the way, tanking the melee, or not tanking, but going into the melee racks right here. Soul Reaper also out in front. When will the Legion team look to go in? They have a couple opportunities. There we go! Behemoth jumps in behind the packs. Poliwhirr Priest gets disintegrated right there. Hellbringer just uses his ultimate as well. And look at the Hellborn team. They are scattering away, but three players are already dead. A Curse getting caught right here, activating his ultimate. Just trying to play the getaway game. Probably will not happen, though. He's getting all the way healed up using his Storm Spear. Just going to play the delay game, and sure enough, he goes down. While it's so busy, he ran away, takes some farm in the middle lane while he's at it, but going to end up having to run away. So the power of initiation, the power of team fight is overwhelming right now. Fnatic MSI, as expected, we said their time was the mid-game, really, but we are starting to hit the later mid-game to the late-game stage. And this is where SK Gaming will start to take a little bit more advantage, especially with a very powerful farm on Flint Beastwood, as he is going to have his next major item very shortly with this already 4,800 more gold saved up at this point. And they're going to make a counter push right here. The Hellborn team still has about 20 seconds or so before their last two heroes are up. I'm not sure on the Conqueror status, as we can look right here. Token of Life, just over 2 minutes, so they wouldn't be able to try to ninja that. They're going to go straight for a push in the middle. They should be able to drop this tower. Here comes Flippies, so leading the way. Hellbringer putting the auto attack damage and vulnerability going to be used. The Hellborn team knows how big this is. They want to try to save as much as possible. Well, that tower will be going down whether or not they like it, and the Legion team will indeed fall back.
I don't know. I feel like MSI, if they had planned originally to go for this kind of a strategy, which it looked like they did from the beginning, they probably should have looked to eliminate more of the long-range heroes, because like the Behemoth and the Myrmidon and the Flint and their really long-range abilities are what is really hurting MSI. I would have expected a Behemoth ban going for this kind of a team, just because Behemoth is so long-range, especially once he gets his portal key for his ult. Like, I don't know. It just seems like a weird choice by them to not take out Flint and Behemoth. Flint being, like, pretty much the most long-range carry in the game.
That he is, so we'll see. Now, this is the interesting part. Now, does Fnatic MSI, do they kind of bang their head against the wall here, and do they keep going for the bottom racks? You see them already heading down here, in fact. The three of them grouped out. We got Poliwhirr Priest back here a little bit, and then Wild Soul not even anywhere close to them, but he can definitely get there fairly fast. He's actually finished his Frost of Skulls we see right there, but Bubbles, in the meantime, he's doing a little bit of a push himself, pressuring the top tower, gets it down to about 485 life before being forced out of there from Wild Soul. So yeah, SK Gaming momentum definitely really on their side now. I mean, you look at the stats advantage on top of that, 60, nearly a 7,000 gold and experience lead at this point. And then you have Angry Tessie on Flint Beast, as we keep going back to the go-to focus here for SK Gaming. He is at 430 gold per minute, and look at that. He picks up a Shield Breaker. So talk about sitting back, just putting out single target damage. He is going to be doing that much more now with that Shield Breaker. Honestly, even more reason for Soul Reaper to perhaps go for a Frost Shield Plate in this case. Again, Shrunken Head definitely has its uses, but with the Sheepstick, but Shrunken Head on Flint Beastwood, definitely not as easy. Whoa, what happened up here, though? Bubbles actually got picked off somehow.
Looks like Entangle. Yeah. I assume Entangle procs got lucky.
Looks like Polly ported up there, too. Might have actually held him in place. Yeah, his tongue tie was on cooldown, Oh, Bubbles gets caught. That's unfortunate for them. He was doing a little bit of a push up there, harassing, but the safe thing is, though, it looks like the Hellborn team isn't pushing. However, they are going for the third Conqueror kill of the game. Bananas will drop this time as well. Will the Legion team react?
I mean, without Bubbles, it's going to be hard for the Legion team to react, honestly. And it looks like I assume SK has an idea that this is what's happening, but maybe they haven't noticed yet. But without Bubbles, it looks like they don't really have any way of stopping this, so they're just going to let it happen. Wild Soul probably going to pick up that token, and that's going to be bad news, honestly, for the Legion team. Wild Soul having two lives. Last time he didn't even lose the token, he had it for
Soul Reaper picked it up, actually.
Soul Reaper picking it up, and Wild Soul picking up the bananas. Bananas are basically a token, though. You just have to time them right, but
Yeah, I mean, in a sense, yeah, they are. But so, sorry, Pierre gets the first time, and now the third time, or the third Conger kill here. And he did actually go Sheepstick, so he went the Sheepstick route. Again, both very, very powerful items. Chose to go the Sheepstick, though, in this case. Now the question is, who's the target that he's going to look to focus it on? Because, obviously, I mean, if you can get at someone on like a Behemoth or Hellbringer, preventing them from getting off good ultimates definitely has effective, but by the time you're even ranged to even use it, they're usually afford to use their ultimates, of course. So that is the problem with that logic there. So in that case, locking down that Flint Beast would definitely be a very ideal use of it. But as we talked about, he does have that Shrunken Head, which is only at this point, I believe, down to a 5-second use time. So we'll see how he uses it. They are going to push in this melee reaction as much as possible. Barrier Idol going to be used right there.
There's the barrier.
Puzzle Box minions, though, doing as much defense. Look at the Polymark Priest was way on. They're locking down Flint Beast. A Behemoth jumps in, though. Flint Beast is barely staying alive. No, he goes down in the end. And down goes Polymark Priest, though. Down goes Phoenix Chester as well. The Hellborn team just sitting on it for. Look at Solreaper. He's got a token alive. He ain't afraid of no freaking ghost. He is charged, and he takes out Myrmidon right there. Bubble's going to use his take cover. Will not be enough. Down he goes as well. A hat trick coming out for Trixie. They are diving the well right here. Bubble's going to buy back. He just wanted to try to save his teammate. If not, oh, is he going to die, though? Oh, he points a completely opposite direction, realizing he had to get out of there. He's going to have his portal key, though. As soon as he comes out of this, he uses it right there. And now just trying to go to it. Look at this. They still haven't killed the Rax yet. They are just going for a tower well dive right here. Finally, they're going to turn around, go for the actual Rax. We see Bubbles doing a little bit of a kite right here on a Wild Soul, kind of keeping him occupied. And if they do not manage to kill the Rax yet, that would be something. But here we go with Beridolon. Wild Soul now here. Invulnerability going to be used by 25. 5 seconds left on Resurrection for Flint Beast, but not able to buy back. So the Rax will be lost, unfortunately, for SK Gaming, and the ranged Rax will too fall. So the Legion team, they did the best that they could with what they had, but just not able to save the Rax. What a very aggressive, just overwhelming play there by the Hellborn team, and Soul Reaper managed to keep the token alive, but Poliwag Priest, that's exactly why he bought that Shrunken Head, so he can port in like that and lock down a specific hero as long as possible. In this case, it happened to be Flint Beastwood, and they just barely got him. I believe the aura ticked him down.
Yeah, no, that was what won them that fight, absolutely. That initiation on Flint Beastwood was perfect. Honestly, I think he was a little too far up. He was kind of ahead of his team, maybe trying to bait the initiation, but rather than baiting the initiation, he ended up dying, so.
That's unfortunate for SK, because that was a huge team fight, obviously, and MSI, they're definitely feeling happy about themselves, taking out those bottom racks, and now SK, of course, will have to worry about that. Definitely, the game is not over yet. I'm not going to by any means go that far. We still have quite a game on our hands. But it is looking more and more scary for SK Gaming. In fact, Wild Soul, he just, I'm guessing, finished his Demonic Breath. No, he has his Charged Hammer, and actually picked up a Shaman's Headdress on top of that, so giving him a little tanky status to deal with both the Hellbringer and the Behemoth Ultimates, on top of that Barrier Isle, of course, from Soul Reaper. So this is very scary now for SK Gaming once again. We are seeing Wild Soul at that very farmed potential. And Legion team, they still have the initiation advantage, and as long as they can get that first and then keep Flint Beastwood alive, you know, not allow him to get locked down, then they definitely have a chance in these fights, as we have seen. But it is definitely easier said than done at this point. Hellborn team, of course, they want to keep up the pressure as much as possible. They're going to go right back into the middle lane and keep it pushed in. We do have Bubbles down here at the bottom side, just pushing back these large creeps as much as possible. Trying to keep them away from the base. Smart play right there, of course. Want to buy them as much time in case they do get a team fight elsewhere. They don't want to have their base being pushed in as well. But even more importantly, perhaps, to all of that, the token of life was not activated by Soul Reaper. He stayed alive throughout all of that, and he still has it. So as tough as he is to kill once, he's going to be gonna have to kill him twice.
Yeah, and that's going to even give MSI, like, if they go for a push here, that almost guarantees that they will probably be able to get the tower, because Soul Reaper alone is huge on their team, and he is so tanky right now with all his support. It looks like Bubble's throwing a shell, but not choosing to initiate yet. Legion being pretty passive, just trying to wait for the right time to initiate it. Let's see what they do. Oh, Poliwag going in again on Flint Beastwood. And Flint Beastwood is going to get taken out again. So that already puts MSI way ahead in this fight. Wild Soul in trouble, though, getting destroyed by the towers and the Flint Beast illusions, but he is going to get away. Soul Reaper getting taken out the first time, his token going down, and now we see Voodoo Jester getting attacked, and he is going to go down. So SK doing a good job keeping this fight alive. Soul Reaper going down the second time, and SK, huge win there in that fight. I mean, honestly, that could have just turned this game around. SK now ahead in experience and gold. I'm pretty sure they were not that far ahead just before that fight.
No.
And that's going to be huge. It looks like Accursed actually getting Cauldron right there, but he is going to get away. Soul Reaper buying back. And he's going to try and stop this push alone, but going in 5v1, not...
Oh, what a Fissure Block!
For Micah taking out... Yeah, that was beautiful, but that... Accursed using Storm Spirit on Soul Reaper to save it. So... And Flint Beast had taken out... Wow. This game is so even, it's ridiculous.
Well, I don't know if I'd use even at this point, because that right there, I mean, that was huge. MSI, they picking off Angry Testy right there after you saw, the buyback on Soul Reapers we're talking about. Looked like the Legion team may have actually been able to pick them off again with that great Behemoth Vigor stun, but then Wild Soul joined the party, and all of a sudden the damage was being output, and Flint Beasthood got caught by the Entangle, love RNG, and was able to get damage down quite easily. So, yeah, that was... definitely a lost fight in the end for SK Gaming. Obviously, Angry Testy had to buy back initially to even help that happen. Hellborn team, though, with 35 seconds left to resurrect on Flint Beastwood. They're going to be able to push in this middle tower, but again, Legion team, even without Flint, they do got quite the turtle. We see Behemoth, of course, is going to line up that Fissure Stun, blocking them off completely, make it even that much harder, but the Poliwag Priest Ward's coming out, the Staff of the Master Awards, you got even more of them. We see Soul Reaper way out in front, and going to get a little bit of sheep there, but the Malorax dropping fast, 10 seconds still left on the Flint Beastwood Resurrection, so they're at least going to loot the Malorax, if not the range. Behemoth figures it's time right now, though. He jumps in with his ultimate. Where's the Hellbringer ultimate? Oh, so 20-second cooldown on that, unfortunately. Behemoth is getting locked down. The Polymer Priest tongue-tied on a bubble. Flint Beastwood is now alive. He's charging in. He activates the Geometer's Bane. But at this point, just too much is lost, more than likely. Behemoth coming back. He's going to throw out a random Fissure Stun. Bubbles with a Shell Surf. But the Hellborn team is just staying alive, as expected. Throwing out the heals all over the place. There goes the ranged Rax. Bubbles does port in, but the lockdown on a Myrmidon. He gets easily taken out. Another Morphling on a Flint Beastwood. And he, too, will go down. And that will more than likely be the GG concede right there. MSI. Yeah. They should be going up 2-0 in this game. The concede vote goes out. There it passes. Fnatic MSI wins the game. They are now up 2-0 here after this. We'll just go ahead and call it game 2. So it is looking shady now for SK Gaming. They're going to have to make an epic comeback here, not only this is the next game, but the whole series as a whole, if they want to come through victorious. But Fnatic MSI, they pull through with a crazy, crazy strategy. It's been a long time since we've seen such a strategy.
Yeah, no, that was huge, and they really played that strategy right. Able to come out, that final fight is what really did it. That buyback from, honestly, like, that buyback from Trixie that allowed them to kill Testy's Flint Beastwood is probably what just won them that game. Like, they were ahead, but that's what let them push for the victory, and they really took it with that buyback and kill.
Yeah, that was just a... I think it's safe to say that I definitely filled the shoes of hoping for an epic game, because from just crazy picks to really a back-and-forth game through a lot of that game, we definitely got that. But MSI, they're showing why they are labeled the best team in the world, and they want yet another title under their belt. They are one game away from doing so, from not only winning $10,000, but being crowned the GOSU Gamers World Cup champions. Will it be so? Will it be so next game? SK Gaming, you gotta bet they're gonna be fighting for their lives, because they know they have everything or nothing to lose, really. They're gonna go out there, give it their best, and try to keep this series alive. So stay tuned. Game 3 coming up next. 2-0 series lead currently in favor of Fnatic MSI. We'll be right back.
Thank you, guys.